And a very good afternoon to you all on this historic Wembley day. The last FA Cup final of the 20th century, and fittingly, two of British football's most famous clubs are disputing this, the 71st final to be staged at this celebrated arena. Two Uniteds, Manchester and Newcastle, are no strangers here. Alex Ferguson's team, indeed, are contesting their fourth FA Cup final of the 90s. The two teams to emerge from the tunnel, and they will tread out into blue skies over Wembley. The sun has been out. The old stadium awash with colour, alive with an ear-splitting crescendo of sound as the teams prepare for the presentations.
Now, and I'm sure he couldn't believe maybe 3 months ago that he would be in this situation.
Well, nerves are so often a factor on days such as these. FA Cup history bears testimony to so many stories down the years of those who've frozen on the day and those who've risen gloriously, magnificently to the occasion. Just listen and look at this atmosphere here at Wembley today. It really takes some believing. Well, some observers have speculated that Manchester United minds, rather than on today, might be more heavily focused on their final match of the season. Starting with Manchester United, no Jaap Stam or Henning Berg because of injury, although Stam is among the substitutes. Dennis Irwin, as I was saying, of course, is out and suspended. In the shake-up, Ferguson pairs David May with Ronnie Johnson in central defence, with Phil Neville on the left. And up front starts with Andy Cole and Ole Gunnar Solskjaer. The side now, the big dilemma facing Ruud Gullit, of course, was whether or not to gamble on Duncan Ferguson, who goes into hospital for a hernia operation on Monday. The answer, well, it's half and half, really. Not in the starting 11, but on the bench, ready to be thrown on. Meantime, the German Timothy Kitzbeyer begins as Alan Shearer's partner. The other question marks, a win over Spurs. The form book sides with Manchester United, the league champions. But so often through the years, this grand old competition has defied logic. Remember Wimbledon in 88, Sunderland in 73. Steve Harper with the kick, launched towards Alan Shearer. The ball for Solano. Schmeichel, just for a moment then, I thought he'd lost his grasp on it. He's featuring a tall today, he's on the bench. Shuttled by an ankle problem. Now it's Giggs, racing away. Good anticipation then by Domi to thwart the threat of Andy Cole. There's some dithering in the background from Chavez. He's got away with it. Troops dejectedly off. Off comes Teddy Sheringham. Instructions there for Ryan Giggs. Well, Ruud Gullit promised his team would be committed. They have certainly been that. He feels they've been holding back, subconsciously or otherwise. Shot go wide here from Gunnar Solskjaer. Been beaten now since back in December. The league champions going for best ever third double. No one has ever done it before. Andy Cole, good play by him. Here's Sheringham. That was deeply dark too, and it scores. Sliding it on to Sheringham! An entrance from Teddy Sheringham. He's only been on the field a couple of minutes. That is some impact.
Well, Sheringham started it, Andy finished it, and it was a tremendous move. It actually went through Steve Harper's legs in the end as he came out, but I mean, it was all Teddy Sheringham showed composure on the ball, always knew what he was. Good play by Cole in the first place. I'm not sure that was meant for Teddy Sheringham, but a wonderful touch. Ball lined up, and I'm not sure that Steve Harper really should have come there, but just watch here, as a delightful ball from Paul Scholes. Harper comes through his legs. I think Harper possibly just showed his inexperience rushing out there, and the defender possibly might have dealt with it better.
He is a player of such outstanding instinct, and he has underlined that again. Here is Solano, he's hit it well. Is Beckham. Now then to Gary Neville. The pick on was from Sheringham, or from Solskjaer rather. More danger then for Newcastle. Giggs. Sheringham trying to hook it across. Finally away, but only as far as David Beckham. Solskjaer. Cole! Is this going to be another one? Oh, hooked away. Almost under the crossbar. back to his right. This is Hammer. Away from Scholes, still deep by Hammer. Great stop by Schmeichel. Manchester United fans, of course, have no forgiving him for choosing Newcastle ahead of their team. Neville's cross, great 1-2 for Sheringham. Fabulous ball in. And Sheringham for that.
Falling over, slipping over, stumbling over. Because to be fair, he's had two or three little openings if he could have sorted his feet out and win off. So they've gained something, and I think they've lost something as well.
Manchester United taking right to left as we look now, starting the second half. Looks of things, Kate Spire. You're tempted to ask why they didn't start with Ferguson, but he isn't fully fit, remember that. Here's Giggs now looking to show his acceleration. Davies Astros quick too. His defensive metal. Not the best of clearances though. He's put his teammates in trouble. That's Sheringham to Scholes! An aberration by Davies Astros, and it's gifted a second goal for United. Scholes, the master goal poacher, strikes again.
Well, it was just as Newcastle started to take a little bit of control, but it's terrible play from Davies Astros there. And then it's a wonderful layup yet again by Teddy Sheringham. And how many times have we seen Paul Scholes score goals from that sort of area? Bags of space, keeps it low, drills it past Harper, gives him no real chance. But it was in the corner where the mistake was made. It was a ball, really. There was no problem whatsoever. Davies could have played it to safety and they could have got reorganised. But he played the ball back into midfield. And there we see the final, what happened from the end of it.
The alertness of Solskjaer, the intelligence of Sheringham, and the clinical finishing of Paul Scholes. 2-0, Manchester United. Sheringham played his part, scored the first, was laid on the second, and United are very much in the driving seat. Beckham in the walls here. To Lee. Looking to attack, gets by away from Schmeichel. Oh, what a clearance from David Bay. Fantastic reaction there to deny gets by a goal. Looking on Griffith. Oh, free header for York. You won't believe that he's failed to cut that one away. Unchallenged in the centre.
Passes there, keeping possession, dragging United all over.
United at their most enduring. Giggs. Hutton shot on the right foot of Wyatt Giggs. Through the middle in support, still York. Got Giggs with him as well. Now Solskjaer. The deflection. An amazing escape for Steve Harper in that Newcastle goal. And that's of Chelsea was one. Who was the other, right?
I think it might have been Eric Thompson.
Just at the top. Alan Shearer. Looking to revive his team's hopes. He hasn't even got the corner. Not his day.
Just secure the win, really. That's obviously what Alex Ferguson is happy to do now. They've got themselves into that winning position. Do nothing silly. And hit them on the break like this.
Giggs. Go all the way through, still Giggs. And Sheringham! Such quick thinking. And he clipped the top of the crossbar. Produced an exhilarating football. And Rudolph's team really had no response for all the endeavour. It was Ferguson through the middle though. Maric up with him. This is Maric! Was a wonderful opportunity and it's passed him by.
Well, they're not going to get a better opportunity than that. Those supporters know it. Maybe that was the chance that might have brought them back into the game. It's a delightful piece of skill to create the opportunity for himself there. Ball opens up and he slides it wide, and I think with that shot that goes wide here goes the chance of Newcastle actually getting back into this game at all.
Geordie's on their feet in expectation. Opportunity a few minutes ago. You felt no hook sagging with it. But now it's Griffin. Right across the face of goal, too. That fixed Michael got his fingers to it. Newcastle felt he did. He's had a change of heart, the referee. He has to put the corner.
Well, David May and Peter Schmeichel certainly thought the game was over then. They were hugging each other, but it was a good save from Schmeichel.
Not called upon here, though. Now he might be. He's been such a dominant force at the moment. He came here with real hopes of upsetting Ferguson's team. They felt they were in with a real chance. It hasn't proved to be their afternoon for the second year running. They can afford to relax, afford to smile now. With one more big occasion still to come. A magnificent season has been for Manchester United. It's two down and one to go. United chasing a unique treble at home and in Europe, have completed the League and Cup double for the third time. The first team ever to do so. First in 94, then 96. And now in the last FA Cup final, the 20th century. They have added success here at Wembley to the league title. The celebrations are on the way. For Newcastle, well, it's another disappointment. Beaten last year by Arsenal, now Manchester United have proved too strong as well. Much better showing from Newcastle this year. At least they can take comfort from that. But it's another marvellous day for Alex Ferguson's team, for whom the success story simply goes rolling on. Their 10th FA Cup win. Fourth time they won it in the 90s alone. Now they'll be setting their sights on Bayern Munich in Barcelona and the Champions League final on Wednesday night.
In Barcelona.
Four FA Cup final wins as a manager for Alex Ferguson. No one has managed that before in the history of the English game. And many, many people will be wishing them well on Wednesday night. I think there has been a feeling that United have their detractors. People don't want them to win things around the country, but there was a poll in a national newspaper today that 86% of those who voted do want them to win on Wednesday night. And they will go there with our best wishes, and certainly a good heart after this terrific display today. Winners over Newcastle by 2-0.
And yet they have the most unbelievable support any other club would love to have it, and even now they've stayed. But what they will witness now is another great moment in this great club's history. Whether you love them or not, they are a great football club. They've built a reputation on a history of triumph and disaster, overcoming setbacks, courage, great players, great people behind the scenes, and of course they too have great support. Roy Keane will lead the team up. Peter Schmeichel took the captain's armband off him when Keane went off. But Keane is the man smiling at the end of this week. Well, he's a strong lad, and it's just as well, because he's going to have to lift the world trophies.
There he goes.
The FA Cup.
You're beautiful, thank you, Sergio. Lovely moment. Unfortunately for Manchester United, that's the end of Roy's season. So the boys will, you know, after a few drinks tonight, I'm sure they'll get their act together for the big one on Wednesday. It's a great moment for Peter Schmeichel to end his Manchester.
One thinks back to the Liverpool units of the 80s. They had to constantly change faces, update the system to keep the hunger for success. Manchester United look to be doing the same thing.
It's a continual change around. Alex Ferguson spent a lot of money last year. Yapstam, nice to see him get a medal. He got off to a tricky start himself this season, but then he showed his true class throughout. And I think Fergie made some nice substitutions, and giving other people, you know, a medal. Like, you know, Yapstam coming on, getting a medal for the last 10 minutes, whatever it was. That's lovely to see.
Now, by my reckoning, and you'll correct me if I'm wrong here, that is trophy number 17 of Alex Ferguson's Manchester United career. And he won one or two in Scotland as well.
Yes, his record is absolutely just, you know, it's got to be Sir Alex.
Four, remember, Manchester United did lose a game at Wembley that season. They lost in the League Cup final, even though it was one of three double years in this decade. Manchester United again have done the double, and now is their chance to go on to become immortal in English football history by clinching the treble involving the European Cup.